Now, most people would know her as being the star goalkeeper for the Matildas, but Lydia Williams is also a proud Noongar woman and advocate for Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people.
Yeah, she's recently teamed up with the Bridging the Gap Foundation to address the healthcare crisis in the Northern Territory and to help raise funds. And Lydia joins us now from Canberra. Good morning, Lydia. It's great to speak to you. It always is. You're doing fantastic work. We're always very, very proud of you. Before we get to the important work that you're doing right now, I have to ask you about the Matildas match coming up next week in Spain. Reason being is that you're going to be the first Matildas goalkeeper to notch up 100 caps. What an incredible achievement for you.
Yeah, I mean, if you would have asked me when I first started if I would be on the eve of 100, I'd probably say you're lying. But, yeah, it's incredible.
How's the team looking?
Yeah, a lot of new faces. It's actually, you know, we're giving quite a few of our players a rest, which is much needed. You know, 2023 is our goal. So kind of whatever we can do to make sure we're peaking for that, I think that's what's, you know, best for the team.
Fantastic. Now, Lydia, I spent the last week in the Northern Territory myself. You've come on board and partnered with the Bridging the Gap Foundation. Can you tell us about the work that they're currently doing in the top end?
They're actually doing a program run by the Menzies Ramachilti Centre and employing, I guess, locals in the Indigenous community to stay and work in healthcare. So it's actually really exciting to see that they're giving a lot of education and the right resources to help the Northern Territory and Indigenous and communities out there.
I love that, and giving scholarships as well to some of these people. Do you think it's important to see Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islanders represented in these types of jobs?
Yeah, definitely. I think, you know, the hardest thing is sometimes from afar recommending something when you're not there living as a local. Mm-hmm. So to employ, you know, locals now, they can actually say this is what we need and get the job done and actually find solutions to problems.
Yeah, it makes so much sense.
It really does, yeah. And the training provides a great career pathway for young Indigenous people too, doesn't it?
Yeah, definitely. And I think that's really exciting to kind of teach the young ones how to live healthy lifestyles. I mean, I think we all remember Healthy Harold.
Yeah.
So you want to have that for the Indigenous communities, something that they remember they can pass down to, you know, younger generations.
Lydia, you're an absolute superstar on the football pitch, but why did you decide to lend your support to this cause in particular?
I mean, growing up in the desert and kind of going out to communities and seeing, you know, what was back then a lot of alcohol, domestic violence. You know, I just want, you know, the Indigenous community to live healthy and have the right, I guess, programs and opportunities to have the support that maybe non-Indigenous people do. And to kind of say that, you know, Bridging the Gap is doing that, I was 100% on board.
You're a superstar. Oh,
you really are, yeah. Saving goals to saving lives. Great job. Lydia Williams, it's been so great chatting to you this morning. You really are awesome. Good luck in Spain, and thanks so much for sharing your insights to us.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations.